Okay, this video is going to go over passing multiple arguments. Before we do that, though, we're just going to take a look at the 5-3, and so you can check what you did and see if you got it right or not. And it doesn't have to be exactly looking like this, but you can take a few moments to see how this looks. If you want to pause the video. I'm not really going to explain this, so as you could pause the video, look at it, compare your answers, and then if you have a question about anything, then just talk to another student or come in and see me. So what we did is we went on to the past one argument intro that we worked on day one, and so what we're going to do here. You don't necessarily have to follow along in JGrasp unless you want to. Otherwise, you can just watch what happens here. So we want to change this to, instead of just passing one argument, we're going to pass two. So we're going to add another variable, and we're going to call it num of cat owners, and we're just going to assign 7 to that just for kicks. And let's say we want to pass this over to the other method through the method call, and there we have two. So now we're going to pass the 7 and the cat over to this method. Now if we were then to go ahead and compile this, however, I did forget to change this. This should say multiple arguments bid. All right. So if we were then to compile it, we're going to see an error here. And so this is important because we want to be able to read our error messages. And so what it says is that the method PetSpeak in class multiple cannot be applied to the given data, types. And basically what it says is the actual and formal argument lists differ in length. That's really the issue here. And if you remember, we did talk about actual and formal arguments. And so that's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to click on this. What the actual... Oh, that's interesting. It said parameters earlier today. But the actual is going to be the ones in here in the method call. And there's two of them there. And in the formal arguments or parameters, there's only one. So they differ in length. One's length, so to speak, is there are two, and this and the in the method call and in the method header, there's only one. So that is going to cause a problem. They've got to match, just like trying to plug in a power cord into, that's made for a Mac and put it into a laptop that's made for Windows environment. So you're going to have a different type of interface there, and that's what's happening here. So there's just not going to, it's not going to match. So what happens then is we go, okay, well then let's go ahead and add this. Now num of cat owners, we're just going to go num just for kicks, and I forgot to put the data type, which is int. And so let's see if that clears everything up. So now we have two parameters in each one, or two arguments in both. And so let's see if that takes care of it. But it says incompatible types. Int cannot be converted to string. And so what happens here is it says int can't be converted to string. Well, here's our int, and here's a string, and here's the string. So what it's saying is the int is trying to be stored in a string, And so what that tells us is that it's the order in the method call has to match the order in the method header, because the first argument is going to be passed to the first parameter. The second argument will be passed to the second parameter. So if these, if the data types don't match, then it's going to give you the error message regarding things not being able to, you know, certain types not being able to be converted to a certain type. All right, then the next thing is then we can just fix that and put, just change the order, doesn't matter which one we change, just change one of them. And what this should do then is give us no cases, no errors. Now we have to finish this because we want to use this number of cat owners. So we can say something like, now we can go num, because that is the parameter variable, which is going to say 7. And then in the string, we're going to go, we'll just say students own a cat. So we run, we go ahead and do this, we run it, and it'll say 7 students own a cat, and so everything works well. So remember, this 7 is returned to the variable call, gets passed to the parameter variable, and that is called in this print statement. So there's your 7. And then the same thing, pet is a variable call, so cat is returned to there. Cat is passed to the parameter variable, and then it's called in the print statement. Alright, that's how it works. Now, we're going to take a look at one more thing. And that is, this, we're going to look at our notes. At the bottom of page 2, there are some notes that we can print in, or put in here. And so, number 22, when passing multiple arguments, the order in which the arguments are passed is the same as the order in which they are received. And we demonstrated that. And then here, of course, you've got some method calls being paired with respective method headers. You have to have a, here's a string and an int. So in the called method, you have to have a string and an int in the same order. Here you have three. You can have three arguments. You can have four, five, six arguments, whatever. So you, here you have a num of classes. That's an int, a double, and a string. So in the method that header of what of the method being called should be the same, the int, the double, and the string. And then another thing that would be good for you to know that you have available to you is an example of passing multiple arguments, and you can see that the these parameter variables don't always get printed. So be careful, you don't think like that, that there's sometimes you're going to be used in assignments, or in this case they would be used in a calculation. All right, so that's it, that's passing multiple arguments.